2021 is a very special moment in history for children in Scotland. It's the year that makes children's human rights the law. An important part of this is making sure we can have our say and be taken seriously.
For 25 years, members of the Children's Parliament have been sharing their views on what kind of Scotland they want to grow up in. Now, for the first time, we've been involved in a citizens' assembly in Scotland about one of the most important issues to us, tackling climate change.
In October 2020, 100 children were invited to join the Children's Parliament to investigate how to tackle the climate emergency as part of Scotland's Climate Assembly.
We all took part in workshops, shared our views in digital surveys, and created artwork showing our visions for Scotland's future.
12 of us became a team of investigators. We've been working together remotely to learn more about the climate emergency with the help of Children's Parliament team and climate emergency experts.
Each month, we got missions in the post to explore solutions for us here in Scotland.
We then met up on weekly Zoom calls as a team.
We learned a lot and came up with lots of great ideas. We also became really good friends and laughed and danced a lot. After 5 months of working together and hearing from the wider group of 100 children, we are ready to share what we think needs to happen in Scotland to tackle the climate emergency. We put all the ideas to votes, so these are our most popular calls to action.
First, we need to change how we eat and where we get our food from. We all need to have a better education about environmentally friendly diets and how to reduce food waste.
We need to see much more food made and sold locally in Scotland. This means helping environmentally friendly Scottish businesses, farmers and butchers. We need to see more plant-based, animal-free options in places where children and adults learn and work. We need to make fresh organic fruit and vegetables more affordable and prices of processed imported food more expensive. We need all foods to have labels telling us where it was made and what impact it has on the environment.
Bella, we need to make lovely community gardens for everyone and teach children and adults to grow their own food.
Next, we need to change the ways we use our land and seas. We need our wildlife, woodland, coastlands and wild spaces to be protected and looked after. We need to stop building on green spaces and create nature parks and traffic-free places where we can play and have fun.
To plant a lot more trees and work with the people who own land in Scotland to make this happen. Members of Children's Parliament want a national tree planting day in Scotland.
All of us need to change how we live and help each other, so these changes are fair. For example, helping people who don't have lots of money to heat their homes. We think we should have shared libraries in towns, cities and villages for sharing toys, clothes, food, books, music, everything.
We also need to add more recycling bins for things that can't be used again and better instructions to follow. We definitely need to make environmentally friendly things in shops cheaper and easier for everyone to choose. This means banning plastic packaging and single-use plastic in Scotland.
We don't always have a choice when it comes to how we travel, but we have lots of ideas for the changes needed to happen.
We also need to make electric cars cheaper and actually make most of them here in Scotland.
We really need to get more people cycling by making safer cycling paths and having sharing bikes in villages, towns and cities.
This would make travelling to school better for the environment and easier too. Lots of us love the idea of walking and cycling buses and think these should happen all over Scotland.
What we have learned is that we really need to learn about the climate emergency and what we can do. We need to make sure children know what's going on or how to get help if they're feeling worried. Children and adults need to learn how to grow food, compost, recycle properly, mend things, and plant trees. This also means spending less time sitting down at school and work so we can do these things.
We need to help our nurseries and schools be better for the environment and make sure all children play and learn outside.
Well, now it's up to you. After listening to what we have told you, we need action now so everyone can grow up and live in a happy, healthy and safe Scotland.
Most of all, we want to know what you want to do next. Please keep in touch so we can work to tackle the climate emergency together. Thank you from all of us at Children's Parliament.